inviting me. This is my first trip to Korea. Has been wonderful. The food is good as well. So I will describe some of the main results in the Virginia thesis by Lei Zhao. And as you have heard in the morning from Shuni, I have been interested in this article. And so also I moved to Virginia a few years ago. It's almost inevitable with my colleague Brian Leonard there that you really want to think or ask a question about catalytic P. And that's basically, you can think of this how the subject arises. And this obviously has not been studied really in the literature. And I hope by the end of this lecture I can convince you there's something interesting going on. And we will fix a field which is very close and capitalize P bigger than 2. Catalytic 2 is often very hard case for the algebra or algebraic group, but in for super algebra we are lucky because we don't want to consider that case. In catalytic 2, super algebra becomes the algebra. We have nothing new to say. So G is the super algebra, that simply means it's C2 graded and has a super commutator. And for the catalytic, it is a notion of restricted. Then this is a restricted super algebra. I will not say it too precise, but basically there are two conditions. And we will see an example very quickly. The even part is a restricted algebra in the usual sense. And of course that doesn't tell you too much if you don't know what that is. But we'll see in the picture. This mapping from even part itself, this is restricted to the algebra. And as the Lisieux algebra, the even part acts on the outer part by a joint action. I want this action to be restricted module. Again, is the word restricted here. So, quickly example. The algebra seems to be everyone's favorite, G of N. In this case, this is also associative algebra. And so, if you have an element here, this P mapping is defined to be X multiply itself P times in the associative algebra product. That is the P mapping. And it has some natural property you can describe. And what I will tell you is what is this P property. You can think that P property in a minute as your the condition or definition restricted. And I'm going to use the following running example which Shuni introduced in the morning, GMM. Even though a lot of these things work for OSP, and basically all what is called basic classical super algebra. And also there's another so-called query super algebra denoted by Qn. That is also an interesting in its own. But for most of the time, I think GMM. Okay. So GMM consists of all these matrix of the size Mn. And the even part is the block diagonal. All the part is the piece of the diagonal. So in particular, the even part contains the GOM plus GLN as an even subalgebra. It's an even subalgebra. So this one, we know how to define this P mapping. P mapping only defined on the even part. And what is the algebra catalytic P, is a key property, is the center of the enveloping algebra contains the so-called a large part. This is mu in catalytic P, so-called P center, Cp of G.
if generated by this element x to the p minus x to the p, where x runs over all the even products about. This is a part of any enveloping algebra, the product. This is a scaling algebra element. You may think that the definition of the shape just makes sense. This element has to be central. That's basically more or less equivalent to this property. Okay. And the second property is to make sure it's central in the whole enveloping algebra, super algebra as well. The second property. You take this element x as 1 and 0. Okay? So, this center is huge. Indeed, this center associated with this center, you can associate a so-called p character, which is a linear functional, again, in premise top of the even part. You can define a reduced enveloping algebra, which is the enveloping algebra G, quotient by the ideal generated by this central element, xp minus x minus p, minus by some scalar, which I will write in this form, for all x even. This p center is a polynomial algebra. In number variable is equal to dimension of the even part. And therefore, this quotient becomes a finite dimensional algebra. Dimension u chi of g is equal to p to the dimension of g 0 times 2 to dimension of g. And it's an interesting phenomenon. For the super-algebra in prime characteristic, we see the cross-characteristic phenomenon, p2. And this is, we will see the phenomenon appear again and again, okay? So, the reason we want to consider this so-called reduced angle in algebra is because of the following effect. Every irreducible representation of this algebra G, it turns out to be finite dimensional. It's always a representation of this u cap g for some time. Therefore, very often you can restrict your module category to this family of finite dimensional algebra, where there are a lot of other techniques. And from the very early on, in the 60s, 70s, people realized really this modular algebra with this p character is really a version of this Cauchy orbit philosophy. One example of that. And that, in particular, is the view taken by Cass and Weisfeller. And so really, for each chi, actually, this algebra doesn't really depend on the choice, it only depends on the Cauchy orbit of chi. And pretty much, you ask how much the representation theory of G is known, then pretty much claim is depends on what chi, which Cauchy orbit you have. Okay. This version of that, in the following numerical statement I'm going to describe. This is the definition. This is just a linear functional. Turns out this linear functional has the important fact that every irreducible representation has to have a p character for some kind. That's the point. P character is not a character is understood in a generalized sense. It's just a linear function. The important part is really, you can start from this sentence. Every user representation has a P character. Okay. But for different choice of chi, the representation theory will vary a lot. So, the first theorem in Lace thesis is what I call it super cutter with umbrella. Well, okay. that means some of these languages indeed appear in climate talk. Let the I denote the co-dimension of the stabilizer of the kite. Since we are in a superalgebra case, you have two parts depending on the I 0 or 1. Okay? The DG chi is the stabilizer. Yeah. Okay. And things like it's known by the cohomology fact that the D0 is always even. That's the dimension of the cohomology. But D1, turns out this in the super case, this is the linear cohomology, this is a super manifold with a super synthetic structure. The other part is become a synthetic form, and it has no dimension restriction, can be even in the top. And this is a funny phenomenon. And the statement says about the super cosmic effect says it's 2 to the dimension D0 divided by 2, which is the integer, and 2 to D1 divided by 2, which is not always an integer, then you need to shift a little bit. In the case, turns out you can increase this by square root of 2. So occasionally you add 1. And this always divides the dimension of every yokai jima. That is what I call super cosmic effect. So some remarks and this theorem one essentially has two parts. I will. This is a part called Morita part equivalence, and this part is the Neoputin part. I'll explain both parts. And if you have a p character which is linear functional, for those of the algebra we are interested in, actually you still have a non-degenerate invariant bilinear form of the algebra, and in particular, which is the even form, and so you still can correspond it. And this is a reductive. The algebra reductive group, it has a Jordan decomposition. So you can still talk about the Jordan decomposition of chi. If chi is equal to chi semi-simple plus chi neopotent in a unique way, then let's turn to the Morita part. This is a reduction procedure from a general chi to neopotent chi. But this chi is really this chi n, but the algebra, the super-algebra you are interested in is becomes the centralized stabilizer of this even part. You are doing a smaller the super-algebra. And then you are reduced to basically to a Neoputin case. This is a Morita equivalence of category here. I think that you asked the same question in premise to the talk. It's the same notation. G chi is the, well, let me see the algebra so I can write both cases. X in G such that chi of X bracket is equal to 0. In the case of when we have the non-degenerate bilinear form, chi corresponds to some the algebra element, then this is really centralized of the corresponding algebra element. Okay. So some case here. The most important case, of course, is when the outer part is zero. That is the algebra case has been studied for many years, and this was due to Friedman and Paschal. Maybe 86, 86 around 86, 87, some time ago. And x. Okay.
Well, for the super algebra, it turns out, in order to realize or generalize the zero freedom and partial, is several super algebra difficulty. The first one is, for the super algebra, it turns out there are three different type, simple root. This even simple root, which what we are familiar in the algebra, is all the roots, there are two types, isotropic or non-isotropic ones. And or in other words, there are three rank one is super algebra, different kind of rank one is super algebra. Then the second difficulty is similar for real. It's not conjugate with opposite. In general, there are lots of non-conjugate Borel for the Lisieux algebra. That's one of the intrinsic difficulty which make the recommendation even in the category zero. Ah. Okay. And in particular, this node is the longest element well group which will bring you the Borel to its opposite. And the third difficulty is is g chi s here. For the algebra case, this is a standard lemma that says this is a Lagrange subalgebra. And the statement turns out to be true is a Lagrange subalgebra G, but with some care, you have to specify what you mean. It's only with respect to suitable choice of Borel. And not all Borel are conjugate. And for this statement, we will only do in the most clumsy way, check case by case. This one line takes probably 10 pages we didn't include in the paper, or more. And I still cannot avoid it. Okay. Then let's pass for the Neo-Gordon case. This is, we talk about the super coupled failure for the Neo-Gordon. In this case, again, in the Lie algebra case, when the outer part is of the super algebra is zero, when the even part is the Lie algebra algebraic group, this is the theorem of Fermat, 95. And how we finally settle this long-standing conjecture of Cartwright-Fellner, the since 70s. And then they are, this approach used the W algebra, which has been a very interesting direction in the continuous theory in the last few years in particular. This is a finite W algebra, not a fine one. Was also very, very interesting, studied a lot in the 90s, but that's a long story. But the finite one appeared and written in quite a diverse area. Over category zero, already very interesting. Lots of things can be done. And then this turns out there are two proofs. And this another proof is the Fermat Scriabin. Maybe 1998-99, roughly. And this used a deformation method. Both of the approach are very interesting. It tell you something new, that there's different things which you know. And since our both approach are generalizable to a super case, here's some subtle point in each case, but anyway, let me just mention this
V1 on as quite a bit of a subtle interesting flavor to this game. And but if we follow the first approach, this will also allow us to introduce the W superalgebra. And this W superalgebra, you can also define the category zero. And I think the Lapentine theory is going to be very interesting. Some of this investigation is under the way. Okay. So, since I mentioned this theorem here, let me also put a remark. And both Huyawa and Dan Natano in the audience, they developed a support for writing machinery for Li Xiu algebra over category zero. The reason is, as you mentioned, finally mentioned multi-category for Li Xiu algebra is not semi-simple. So therefore, there's something the support variety can be non-trivial. And they use that to also prove over category zero. Over C, there is some kind of two power divisibility. And I think, it's possible to strengthen this superalgebra subset somewhat by fusioning with their two divisibility. Their two divisibility depend on the block. This notion, this statement is really dependent on a chi, but for U chi G module, still there are lots of different blocks there. Maybe for different blocks, the divisibility certainly can vary. So for the super algebra, this notion of additivity number for the super algebra, and this number. The two power, this number enters the two power in this divisibility. And I think if we formulate this statement in block wise, and this way of adding certain additional two power to this case, maybe even the proof of this premise idea is you find some subalgebra of right dimension to prove every G module is free over that algebra. Over that enthalpy algebra. And I think their idea is you can support by they cook up some clipped algebra eventually. And this representation of a clipped algebra has certain dimension. So this representation has two divisible dimensions by two somehow. And probably if one makes the right choice, these two algebra, you may even expect some algebra which is combined by these two, this representation will still be free over. That's a large algebra. Okay. So, anyway, I'm not going to describe that in detail, but let me since I mentioned this activity, and it's just natural to ask, in general, what are the irreducible characters look like? This is very hard problem in category P. Essentially, when the p character chi is zero, that's a Lucy conjecture. But for the superalgebra, still there are some cases we can see something. And that's the next thing I would like to describe. So there are some block on with this activity number to be zero. This case is what Katz called the typical in category zero case. This case is roughly speaking is the kind of the super algebra, this super phenomenon disappear. That's is roughly what it means. And the underlying well group of the even sub algebra control the linkage in various things. And so in this case, we can indeed expect some good pattern. So let me introduce a definition. A way, lambda is called a way.
typical.
If the following numerical inequality code, if the product of lambda plus rho alpha this bilinear form, product over all the positive roots, I'm choosing some positive root distance somewhere, if this is positive. Rho is probably the half sum in the super sense of the positive root.
Okay.
And this is some numerical condition. So in this case, in the case like GOMN, this algebra is C2-graded, but actually this algebra is also naturally C-graded. And C-graded with the middle part is yet an even sub-algebra. It's G0, it's also C-grading or C2-grading. But this also up-triangular part, block up-triangular, also block lower triangular. You see this triangle decomposition is G minus 1, is G plus 1. This is C-grading. And this C-grading is compatible with the C2-grading of the Dissolve algebra. In other words, the type A Dissolve algebra contains the even sub-algebra as a Lapi sub-algebra. And this is not always true for the Dissolve algebra. For OSP, most of the time, it's not true. That's why OSP, for the Lapi field, is much harder than calculations. And this type of phenomenon is working for some additional Dissolve algebra as well, usually under the name of type 1. But let's not worry about that. You just take this as your favorite example. So the second theorem I'd like to describe about Lay, by Lay, is the following. So you can talk about, since chi is a p character only for the g is defined to be the linear function on the even part, so really you can make sense of this reduced enveloping algebra for this even part of sub-algebra as well. And you can talk about the module category of this, and also module category of the algebra g. In general, of course, module category of the algebra and the sub-algebra is a very little connection, precise connection. But we can restrict to the so-called typical subcategory. Roughly speaking, those irreducible modules with composition factor, each irreducible, the high weight is typical. You can define such a thing. And each typicality is an invariant under block. So this is really, so you are picking out a certain block for a regional module category you are interested in. And you can introduce, this is a sub algebra, you can introduce an induction function from G0 to G1, then induce to G. And this has an inverse function by taking the invariant under G1. And the theorem says this is a equivalence category. In the case of the algebra over category 0, like you mentioned, the typicality, typical case is a kind of boring case. This is the case you can get a wild type of character formula, but the block is semi simple here, very boring. But over category P, that's no longer the case. So this theorem becomes interesting and non trivial. So let me indicate two consequences of this theorem. One is from the work of Mr. Pavlikov, Mikovich, and Rimini over this calculated p-localization theorem in the last couple of years. And you know quite a bit about the recondition theory on this one. Okay. And in particular, but with this equivalent category, basically, is whatever you know this side, you know what the corresponding Dissolve algebra. And the typical condition for the algebra is a kind of funny one. When you do the block-wise, this further becomes into lots of different blocks. Even some block of a typical one in the algebra case will be equivalent to the non-typical one. The typical condition here is really doesn't really matter. Okay? That's why you don't this condition anyway. This is only used to pick out something here to identify with this stuff. And so in particular, this BSR statement would, among other things, imply, tell you the number of simple modules in UK of G. Not in this, that's not true. In the regular typical block for U chi of G of this mutual particle. And this is given by the dimension of the cohomology of the spring fiber of the underlying black manifold, the even part of the spring chi. Basically, we just, that's for the G theorem, this is part of this theorem, or the consequence of this theorem. This was conjectured by Humphreys or Lutzig in the 90s. Another, so this one, just notation, this is spring fiber. This theorem very much even called for a geometric study of geometrical Hondian theory for supergeometry. Basically, in the most special case, typically it's the most special case for the supergeometry. And this case already is the statement, they are geometric statement you can make. And the second consequence I could mention is, even in the case of chi equal to zero, this is called a restricted envelope in algebra. The study of this corresponds to the modular category of the Venus kernel by tensor products in a Feynman. Basically, anything about algebraic group representation, essentially, if you have an irreducible character, reduced to this case. So therefore, in this case, Lutzig conjecture applied. You use the Lutzig character formula as in Bryce top applies to G theorem. But anything you about G theorem you can carry over the same thing apply to U theorem of G of no theorem anymore. Regular to this regular block, and this side is a regular typical block. Okay. G to be G 1 1, and in this case there's only one block is so-called not typical. This case occurrence of atypic number can be 0 or 1 for different blocks. 0 is typical case, there's only one additional case, and so the non-typical case is only one block there, right? And hence this non-typical block in this case can be described in terms of quiver. You really have a quiver algebra model of quadratic relation. And this quiver is type A fine type A quiver. Zero, one, two, P minus one. And you all see a double line everywhere, and arrow goes to opposite direction. And each arrow you label then this quadratic relation you can write down in terms of this. I claim in this case already non-typical block. This occurs simplest case in the beyond the semi-simple. In a super algebra case, but it's really describing in terms of such a classical object. Okay. So,
this theorem too leads to several questions which for now is no answer. Which is, what do you go beyond the typical case? Or how do you formulate anything like conjecturally, even loosely type of conjecture for the regular non-typical flows? And this is how last couple of years Shuni was talking about. We managed to do overcast this theorem. This one super duality works really well. Kachanlu theory, if you formulate things right for super algebra and non-super, they match perfectly. So we would like to see in this cardinality case whether anything non-typical, the answer is the multiplicity of these irreducible intensible baby Fermi in terms of other well module can be given, always given by a fine Kachanlu polynomial. That will be truly amazing if this any version of the super duality in the cardinality case. In the last few minutes, I will describe another theorem, which is as a little different flavor. So, obviously, algebra like GLMN or other interesting one which we can have triangular decomposition as usual. So, by using the algebraic group to change the choice of the p capital, we can always assume the chi annihilates the even part of M plus. Then this allows you to define the baby Fermat module, just as in the usual case. So, if you set up this particular weight set called lambda chi, which are those with weight lambda satisfying the condition lambda applied to the curl root for the p power minus the lambda of h alpha is equal to chi of h alpha to the p for any alpha. And this is some finite set. And this u-chi module of chi weight has to come from here. And for this lambda here, you can define the so-called baby Fermat module, which we denote by C chi of lambda. It's defined to be induced module from one dimensional one. You can have C chi, which is C lambda. So for lambda coming from here, so this is a representation for H. And this you can extend to N plus because of the condition. And you can think in terms of u-chi module. Then you induce to the OG. Okay? So the unit number 3 tells us the following. When a baby Fermat is inducible, this is only a finite dimension module. That's why baby Fermat, not Fermat. The dimension is already P2, the dimension of N minus even part times total dimension of N minus other part. Okay, so still. Three. Okay, so. And so again, basically the theorem is good for any basic classical super algebra. Also for Qn, you will reformulate this theorem, which we prove actually for Qn. So, C chi of lambda is irreducible if and only if the following numerical inequalities, the product over even positive rows alpha of this factor lambda plus rho tending with alpha to the power p minus 1 times product over outer positive rows beta and lambda plus rho beta. This is number 0. And this is part 1. Turns out, as a consequence of part 1, you can obtain a semi-simple, semi-simplicity criterion for the u-chi of p.
U chi of G is a semi-simple finite dimensional algebra if only if chi is still really the regular semi-simple. Or the corresponding the algebra element under the non-negative Abelian form is a regular semi-simple element. The centralized is chi. So this theorem, part one of Omnibus, or generalize the algebra results of Rudolphov, and I think Breda and Pasha also has some other approach to this semi-simplicity. And this again a simple algebra difficulty. Yes, this for real sub-algebra are not necessarily countable. And there are lots of different simple root systems around. And turns out you really need to manage to change from a Borel to its opposite or basic to any other Borel. Now you need to involve the notion of auto reflection, which you should mention but didn't really define, which allow you to auto reflection like the usual simple reflection. You only change the simple root by at one point. But now if you are doing the change on the outer simple root, not on the usual even simple root. Not the, but you are still able to do that. And the process is more subtle, and it has some weird super phenomenon there. And once you are able to do that, turns out the statement is very much look like as you showed it, but it's in the case of OSP, the proof is quite a bit harder. In the type A case, this is true proof. You can prove like OSP using auto reflection. You can also actually the theorem 2, the typical that's going to help you to get around as well. And so that's the three theorems I like to talk about very much about the modular recognition of the supercomputer. But these some other things, very much some of these general results indicate there's quite a bit going on for the supercomputer in catalytic P. And for the atypical case or non-typical case, I think I would really love to see whether there's any way or even formulating rooted type of conjecture. And the basis of that will be the linkage principle. For some class of algebra that can be done, type A is a variation of that is in Kuyawa's thesis. Essentially is a linkage for catalytic P of the super-algebra or supergroup. And for OSP 1 to n, also there should be an algebraic way of really deriving this linkage based on Dalti and those people's approach. And but anyway, any non-trivial example, we pretty much like to see that and to see how it turns out. Okay, I think that's all I want. Thank you.